The Multimach CCX is one of the newer Iron Banner weapons that, honestly, on first glance, I didn't really think much of. But I just so happened to get some pretty interesting rolls of this weapon, and after trying them out, I was pretty surprised at how good this SMG felt. I think traditionally in Destiny 2, we've been used to a 600 RPM SMG meta, not that SMGs have ever really been meta, I guess maybe early on in year 1, but I digress. The point being is the Antiope archetype, or Antiope, or Antiope, however you want me to say that, has been known as the best archetype for SMGs, mainly because that archetype tends to have some really high range, and that trend continued on the spiritual successor to the Antiope, which was the Friction Fire. However, this weapon here, this 900 RPM lightweight SMG, actually breaks that mold a bit. Traditionally, the only 900 RPM SMG I really loved up until this weapon was the Mita Mini Tool. I can't really explain why. I wish it had better stats in some way, but it's just a weapon that always felt really good to me, and it always felt like it shredded. The Multimach takes everything I love about the Mini Tool and amplifies it to the level that I'd love it to be at. On one hand, it's a bit disappointing that the Mini Tool doesn't have these kind of perks and potency, but on the other hand, it's really great to see a 900 RPM lightweight SMG that really shows the full potential of the archetype. Of course, being a lightweight 900 RPM SMG, it has that really fast optimal time to kill of 0.67 seconds, and a base time to kill that's a little on the slower end, the slowest of all the SMGs, with 1.13 seconds. So that's a pretty good disparity. You want to hit your headshots with this, and if you do, you're going to be well rewarded. And that optimal time to kill doesn't mess around. It's why I love using the Mini Tool, and this weapon, of course, has that same potential, which makes it a lot of fun, and it actually can do it at some better ranges. I happen to get two pretty great rolls of this weapon. The first one had 53 range, 53 stability, 80 handling, 33 reload, 55 aim assist, 1.6 times zoom or 16 zoom, of course 100 recoil direction, and a 36 bullet mag. It's got the Model 6 loop sights, which is medium zoom, so it's plus 3 zoom with a benefit to range and handling on top of that. It also has accurized rounds, killing wind, and kill clip, a very, very lethal combination, especially on an SMG, and then is topped off by a stability masterwork. My other roll, which is slightly less lethal but still incredibly interesting, has 84 range, so a massive amount of range, only 10 stability, 73 handling. Other stats are the same, of course, other than the zoom, which this one has a 1.7 times zoom, and that's because I got the Model 8 red sights, which give plus 4 to zoom and plus 12 to range, which is very good, probably the ideal sight. It gets accurized rounds, killing wind, Iron Reach, the new perk that gives a massive boost of range at the cost of stability, and a range masterwork. So I actually wanted to start by talking about this roll, because this was a really interesting roll on this SMG because of how much range it could get. That's an insane amount of range, but nearly no stability. Now, is that worth the trade-off? I'm happy to report that it's actually a lot more wieldy and controllable than you might think, and that really shows how impactful the buff to SMG stability was. Now, SMGs still recoil, the weapon still recoils itself quite a bit and has the same amount of recoil, but what they did was they reduced the amount of screen shake, which is debatably the most jarring and annoying part of recoil, so that it feels a little easier to control and actually use. Even though the weapon does have its own recoil, you still have to control for that, but your screen's kind of not going all over the place and going crazy while that's happening. And even with this low stability of only 10 stability, the high zoom and the high range still felt like it kept it usable, like surprisingly usable. It was a lot of fun to use this. And while I'm not sure that I'd make this my main role of this weapon to use, it was, again, surprisingly usable and a lot of fun to have that much range on an SMG between the 84 range and such high zoom. It felt like it could challenge quite a bit with pretty decent consistency, better again than I would have thought. And I think a good part of this is because its recoil direction, this weapon's recoil direction, is inherently 100, which is nearly perfectly vertical, and whether you're using a 10 stability roll or a 53 stability roll like my other one, the recoil is still mainly vertical, and that means it's a lot easier to control because all you have to do is kind of tilt down on your right stick a bit. Of course, it's different for YMNK users, but me as a controller user, tilt down on your right stick a bit, use your strafe to kind of follow the other targets, and you should be in a pretty decent place. And that's really, I think, what makes this weapon usable, even with an insanely low stability stat. Now, this mega thick range multi-mach gets 25 meters of optimal damage range, so we only start getting damage drop off after 25 meters, and with Killing Wind active, that gets boosted to 29 meters. Some pretty crazy ranges for an SMG. Now, although the mega thick range was nice and the stability wasn't as bad as I thought, like I said, it still wasn't my favorite to use as my main role this weapon. My other role, which had Killing Wind and Kill Clip like I mentioned, definitely was my favorite role of this weapon to use. This thing was incredible. Because SMGs play best in this close mid-range where players are typically rushing you or you can catch someone out of cover, because of course it's a full auto weapon, it doesn't really do well against weapons that play cover, I think that kill perks are just more favorable. I think SMGs really feel like they play at their best when you can just continually loop these kill perks like Kill Clip, like we've seen for so many years in the Antiope, and just repeatedly shred people in close mid range and keep baiting them out of cover, force them to overcommit with a special weapon like a shotgun, or catch a hand cannon user off guard, and really just repeatedly shred targets. I think that's when SMGs really feel like they're at their best. And because SMGs are full auto weapons and they deal very little damage per bullet, they struggle against high DPS weapons, like the meta of the aggressive hand cannons currently. So I don't think it's actually worth getting that mega thick range as a trade-off when you could be getting Kill Clip. I think that SMGs, as much as range matters a lot, I don't think it's worth giving up that kill perk, because you're not really going to be doing great against those high DPS weapons at range anyways. You want to double down on the fact that you want to shred through people repeatedly in close mid-range. Of course, the additional range helps you in case you need to challenge someone from a little further, you're out of your engagement distance, and maximize on your engagement distance, but I don't think that's worth it at the cost of your lethality perks, which really, again, make SMGs perform at their best. With Kill Clip active, this thing's already great 0.67 optimal time to kill goes down to an insane 0.47 optimal time to kill. That is incredibly quick. And with Kill Clip, if you only hit body shots, your base time to kill is your previous optimal, 0.67 seconds. That is insane. That shreds. The base range of this roll is 19 meters. Honestly, if I had a range masterwork or maybe the plus 4 zoom sights on this, I'd probably get 20 meters of range out of this, which is phenomenal for a base stat. But when we factor in Killing Wind, that boosts up to 21 meters. And remember, Killing Wind and Kill Clip activate together, which means you're not only getting more damage, you're getting more range. And while Kill Clip is giving you a faster time to kill, we also have to remember that it is just boosting your damage. And when you combine that with Killing Wind, it gets pretty significant. Because yes, you're going to get an insanely fast time to kill within 21 meters, but simply because of the damage boost, we're also getting more range before we get back to our normal damage numbers. So for example, even though we're not getting a faster time to kill at something like 28 meters, that's still the range that we have until hitting what was our previous normal damage numbers. So the way to think of this is you have 21 meters of a 0.47 optimal time to kill, or you have 28 meters of your normal time to kill without Kill Clip, even though, again, Kill Clip's active and that's what's making it possible. 28 meters of a 0.67 time to kill is still phenomenal. That is still insane and is going to be very problematic to a lot of weapons like the 120 hand cannons if they're even remotely caught out of position. And we're at the end of the video and I didn't even get to mention that, of course, being a lightweight weapon, this boosts your sprint speed, something that is no longer available on hand cannons, and as a result makes this more desirable to use, especially if you crave fast-paced gameplay where you get to go from target to target just shredding them. And naturally, lightweight does give you an additional 2 tiers to your mobility while this weapon is out, which is great specifically for hunters for your dodge cooldown and min-maxing your build. And this weapon honestly is a joy to use with a sniper, or I guess if you're just a really fast-paced player that wants to dominate the close mid-range, yeah, you could pair this with a shotgun. But for me, this has been such a fun time to use with a sniper, and I really think this is one of the best SMGs in the game, if not the best SMG in the game, which is a nice change of pace to see a different archetype being the most desirable. So next time Iron Banner rolls around, I highly recommend getting one of these and picking one of these up if you can. And yeah, while you might be thinking that the Iron Banner loot pool is massive and you can play for an entire week and barely get anything that you want, well, I'd just say, just earn it, dude.